Get ready to match the stars. Bert Convy. Brett Summers. Morey Amsterdam. Carolyn Jones. Richard Dawson. And Betty White. As we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game 73. And here's the host of Match Game 73.
Hello, Johnny Olson. Thank you very much. Hello, ladies. I greet you.
I greet you.
Is everybody ready?
Yes, I hope the show will be a big hit and you'll be able to afford a haircut.
So you've met the stars. Now let's say hello to our two players here, Chris Jones and Sue Yannick. Hello there, ladies. Chris here is our current champ. She's won one game, has $600 to her credit, and she's a very pretty lady, as is Sue Yannick. Would you refresh our memory, Sue, and tell us a little about yourself?
I'm a student at UC Santa Barbara majoring in political science, and one day I hope to be a lawyer.
Okay, good luck to you. We'll start this game right after this. All right, here we go. You've met our two ladies here. If you're all set, ladies, we'll begin with round one. All right, Sue, would you make a selection, please?
I'll choose A.
A is what she wants. You know, sometimes you'll find some of these questions more difficult than the others. That's why we ask you to make the selections there. And it's entirely up to you. Here we go. Everyone plays. Inez was a contortionist. I'm not even finished.
I can't wait to write that one.
Inez was a contortionist. She could touch her nose to her blank. All right, Sue, you will think of an answer.
To her blank?
Inez was a contortionist. She could touch her nose to her blank. As soon as you're all finished, I'm surprised at you having trouble.
You think I have trouble? You should see Inez.
Okay. Sue, we call for your response now. Inez was a contortionist. She could touch her nose to her...
Her nose to her toes.
Her nose to her toes? Oh, boy. That's really very difficult, isn't it?
Yes.
Toes is the answer we're looking for,
Toes
Bert.
Is the answer we're looking for. I don't know about toes, but I'd pay $1.25 to see Inez touch that.
What did you say?
He says Fanny. Okay.
She tried it, and that's how she met her end.
Ooh.
I want to thank you for this sitting ovation.
Brett, may we see your answer? Toes is what we're looking for.
Well, toes and nose and rhymes and all that, but I said belly button because it sounded a little more sensible.
Belly button? Yeah, that
I can do that.
That's what we used to say at the Naval Academy.
Okay. What do you say? I guess it was a contortionist. You could touch her nose to her
foot.
To her foot. Oh, gee, we can't match that. No match there. Too bad. All right. No. Okay.
It did match.
Oh, yeah. Good. Okay. Thank you for your assistance, Richard. All right, Carolyn.
Oh, good. I'm a fan of automatopoeia. I said toes.
Okay. So you got another match, Sue. Richard?
She could touch her nose to her back. The only thing is you couldn't tell if she was coming or going. Poor devil.
Okay, there she goes. What do you say, Betty White?
I, too, am a fan of onomatopoeia. I loved her in... What was that Betty Davis picture? She could touch her nose to her rear.
Oh! Okay, so you scored twice there with that, and now let's see how Chris does with this. Everyone plays.
Do I play?
Yes. Oh. Everyone plays.
Okay.
You're everyone,
Carol. Said everyone plays, Carol.
Everyone.
Don't fight children.
As in anyone.
Wanda told her psychiatrist...
Who?
Wanda.
Oh.
Wanda. Told her psychiatrist she couldn't bear to blank her husband. That lady screamed. think Wanda's in the audience. Did you hear that, Chris? Wanda told her psychiatrist she couldn't bear to blank her husband. All right, this tear is ready.
Oh, I just learned to print.
All right, now, Chris, we call on you for your response. She couldn't bear to blank her husband.
Divorce.
To divorce her husband is her response. Let's see if that scores for Chris. Bert Convy, may we see your answer?
Yes, she couldn't bear to kiss him is why she wanted the divorce.
I see. Okay. She couldn't bear
to divorce her husband.
What do you say, Brett?
Stop being married to Jack Klugman, divorce is my line, so I didn't use it. Fight with.
Couldn't bear to fight with her husband. Okay. Maury, what do you say?
She couldn't afford to shoot her husband. Guns cost too much today.
I see. Wanda told her psychiatrist she couldn't bear to blank her husband, Carolyn. What?
Well, I think Bert and I were meant for each other. Kiss.
Kiss. Okay. Uh-oh, watch it. Oh, oh, get back. Get down here.
Yes,
remind me to put saltpeter in his drink.
I'm
in
the seat 3 days.
That's fine for him. What are you
going to
do for me?
May I refresh you?
Oh! I have a veterinarian I could recommend.
We can't hear too well up here. Did you say St. Peter?
May I refresh your memories as to what the real purpose of this meeting is?
Actually.
See, she responded to Wanda told her psychiatrist she couldn't bear to blank her husband with the word divorce. Now we call on you for your response.
Couldn't
bear to bear.
The story of the two bears and a child from a previous marriage.
What do you say, Betty White?
She couldn't bear to kiss her husband, and Bert Convy blew me a kiss from the top.
Oh, you got it. Oh, oh, he really does get around. So, at the end of round one, Sue Yannick is ahead, our challenger, 2-0, and we'll go to round two. And, Sue, we ask you to make the selection.
I'll take B this time.
B it is. Now, last time you matched Carolyn and Morey, and so the two of you will lay out this time. You'll be trying to match all but those two. No one would play golf with George anymore because he blanked so much. No one would play golf with George anymore because he blanked so much. Ready, Bert?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now, Sue, we call on your response. Because he blanked so much, what did George do?
He cheated.
He cheated so much. That's what she said. Bert, what do you say?
I said he swore too much.
He swore too much?
Yes, on the golf links.
Bert, her answer is cheated. What did George do?
Bert Convy isn't wearing any cuff links.
Bert he isn't.
Joe!
Not all you had to do. That's
you
terrible.
Forgot your cuff links.
I forgot.
But I love him
swore.
Anyway.
Swore. That's your answer, swore.
Well,
okay.
I tell you what Brett isn't wearing.
Okay, Morey, may we see yours?
I thought you told me not to write.
Oh, I'm sorry, you're right.
Sure. I'd like to welcome you to the show.
Richard Dawson.
Did you leave any family? He swore too
swore
much.
Swore too much. All
person.
Right, her answer is cheated. Let's see if you got a match with Betty White.
She knows George and I know George. He cheated.
He cheated. She swore once. Okay. Now, as we come to the second half of this last and final round, Chris, I remind you, you must match three celebrities to stay in the running. Four, however, will win it for you. All right, everyone will participate. This
even
is
Carolyn?
It.
Even Carolyn?
Yes.
Even
What's
poor
that?
Little Miss
Even
Muppet.
Carolyn?
Even Carolyn.
Okay.
Arthur said, Phyllis is a blank head. Arthur said, Phyllis is a blank head. Tie, 4-0, Chris. We'll get your response, Chris, in a moment, as soon as they're finished. Okay, they are now ready. How do you fill in that blank? Phyllis is a blank head.
Meathead.
Meathead is what she said. Well, that's currently a popular expression due to the big hit TV show. Bert, what do you say?
Yeah, I said he would have said a hothead, however.
Hothead
yes.
is what you say. Okay, Brett.
I'm not even sure what it means to be perfectly candid, but I said hophead.
Hophead?
Yeah.
All right. Let's
go. Use that in referring to frogs.
Phyllis is a blank
I head. I said he was a knothead.
A knothead. Now, Chris, you must match Carolyn, Richard, and Betty to stay in the game. Let's see if it happens. Must match them all.
Well, I thought she was very intellectual, so I said egghead.
Egghead! So our winner is Sue Yannis. Congratulations. Right here, if you please. Congratulations to you. You've got $100 for winning the game. And now it's time to say goodbye to this pretty lady. She's going to leave with $600. Thank you, Chris Jones. Nice to meet you. Bye. Okay, we'll get back to you and have a go at the Big Money Supermatch right after this. Sue Yannick has won her first game here. She's got $100 to her credit. Now she's going to try and win the big money here, $5,000. You ready?
Yes.
Okay, we polled a previous studio audience, and we got their best response to this. Dumb blank, or dumb blank, whatever inflection you want to give it. Now, the answer given most often by that studio audience is worth $500, Sue, if you can match it. The second most frequent response is worth $250, and the third, $100. Now, the celebrities are allowed to help you, three of them, that is, so you can start choosing now and get their responses one at a time.
Betty White?
How would you fill in that blank, dumb blank?
Well, I happen to be an authority, dumbbell.
Dumbbell is what she said. Okay, another one?
Morey Amsterdam.
Morey?
Dumb bunny.
Dumb bunny. Well-known phrase. One more, Sue.
Carolyn.
Dum-dum.
Dum-dum. Okay, I like the reading, too. Dum-dum. All right, so you got dumb bunny, dum-dum, and dumbbell. You may choose one of those as your answer, or give us one of your own if you like, but we call for your answer now, Sue.
Dumbbell.
Dumbbell is what she wants. Okay, that's the one Betty White gave you. We are looking for dumbbell. May we see the $100 response? Dumb blonde.
Oh.
That one never showed up at all. Well, you know how dumb blondes are. They never go outside. We are looking for dumbbell. May we see the $250 response? Dumb bunny. That's up there. Morey gave you that one. All right, Sue, here is your third and last chance to find dumbbell. May we see the $500 response? Dumbbell it is. So you've got the $500 you've won in the audience match, and that means you can now play for 10 times that amount, or $5,000. You do that by matching... a little late with the ping there. Don't ping until I tell you to ping, or ping when you're supposed to ping. Ping now.
That's Avon
good.
Calling.
Okay, Avon is now. Okay, now, here in the... to go for the $5,000, you must match one celebrity on a head-to-head basis, and we ask you to make choose a celebrity now. Make a selection.
Betty White.
You're going to try Betty White. All right, Betty. You get ready to write, and you face me, Sue, and I'll get the question. Here we go, $5,000. Write your answer to this, Betty. Blank grapes. Blank grapes. No help from the audience, and I'll tell you why. Your answer may be rotten. That's the only reason you don't want to. Okay, Betty, you're finished?
I'm completely in the business.
All right, now we ask Sue to give us her response to this. Blank grapes.
Sour grapes.
Sour grapes is what she says, Betty, for $5,000. May we see your answer?
Sour grapes.
Try and pull myself together.
Aren't you playing?
Now, listen, you better take a deep breath because you're shaking a little bit here. I know it's exciting to win that amount of money. You got $5,600, but you better pull yourself together because you're going to meet another challenger and play another game. So let's meet another player right now. Hello there, Bob Rebin. Okay, now I'll help you up here, Sue. Say hello to Bob there. That's Bob Rebin. Right, Bob?
Yes, sir.
Where are you from, Bob?
I'm a police officer for the city of Los Angeles. I reside in the San Fernando Valley with my wife.
Well. Nice to hear a police officer applauded there. Good luck to you. You know how this thing goes here? You know,
yes, sir.
You'll be answering questions, trying to match the celebrities. You get two chances. And the one who's matched the most celebrities at the end of the second round wins, gets $100 for that, then has a chance at the $5,000, which this lady just won. And it's really exciting, as you saw. Are you all ready?
Yes, sir.
All right, you make the first selection, Bob.
B.
B is what he wants. We have a new game, everyone plays, and this is it. John lost his trained flea and marries blank.
I beg your pardon, sir.
John lost his trained flea and marries blank.
In Mary's... In?
That's what it says. In Mary's blank.
That's the man, officer.
What did he say?
Okay, as soon as you're ready, we'll get Bob's response here. Let's have a little respect for law and order there.
Right.
What are you doing, Brett? Writing...
Ah! I'm all
over it. Okay, now Brett's ready. So Bob will ask for your answer now. John lost his trained flea and Mary's...
Hair.
Hair is what he says. So Bert, we'll call on you first and see if you match.
I confess, officer, in her hair.
Hair it is. So Bob, you score once. Brett?
It's so warm up here, I can't tell you.
Really?
Yes.
It's a hot studio, isn't it?
Mm-hmm. Hair!
Hair it is. Here's another one for you.
I hope I heard correctly. She lost her trained flea at where?
John lost his trained flea in Mary's blank.
I said kennel club.
Kennel club. You are an imaginative fellow. Dumb answer, but you got a lot of imagination. Okay, Carolyn.
Well, I was very confused, so I said furniture.
Well, you were confused. I'm sorry about that. So the train flea is somewhere in the furniture.
Yeah.
Were you confused, Richard?
Whenever there's a policeman around, I'm never confused. Hair.
Okay, so you're up to three. What do you say, Betty? Hair is his answer.
Mary was starting from scratch. Hair.
Hair, yeah. You got four there. Okay, we'll get to your half of the round. 4-0 in the middle of round one here. But first, we've got to have a few words with you about this. Okay, here we are in the middle of round one. We've completed Bob's end of the round. He has matched four celebrities, and now let's see what we've got for Sue here. Everyone will participate. Harvey and Maureen broke a campus record by blanking for 100 hours without stopping. You don't think that's a record? All right. You did hear the question and understand it.
Oh, yes.
Harvey and Maureen broke a campus record by blanking for 100 hours without stopping. They're all finished, so Sue will call on you for your answer.
For kissing.
For kissing. That's your answer? I guess the audience likes that answer, too. All right, kissing is her answer. Bert, what's yours?
I guess it's possible if you breathe through your nose and kiss for 100 hours.
Well, you certainly can't breathe through your ears.
Oh, you certainly can.
Brett, what do you say?
I think that's impossible. Even in my youth, I couldn't kiss for 100 hours.
You couldn't?
No.
Let's try it.
I said dancing.
That's not a bad answer. All right. Her answer is kissing. Maury, what's
I came up also with kissing, and it saves a lot of air pollution.
Okay. So you scored twice, Sue. Now, Carolyn, what do you say?
Well, I read all those things about what they do in those crazy colleges, and I said kissing.
Kissing it is. Okay. 4-3 now. Let's see what Richard
I went
did.
Out with a young lady right after they broke that record, and her lips were too tuckered to pucker. To sing.
Okay, the score is tied at this moment, and let's see what Betty White does.
They held the record until recently, and then Henry beat them. Henry's kissing her the radio. Ah.
So you forge ahead, Sue.
No.
5-4, the score. So that's the end of round one, and we'll come back to you in just a moment or two. We have to stop here, folks, right now, because our time is just about up. The score is 5-4, and we'll pick up with round two the next time we get together, okay? I'd like to say thanks to all of you, and I want to find out about your new project. Brett, you want to tell us about that?
Yes, I'm doing the Perry Mason Show, and we're on Sunday nights at 7:30, and...
You're going to be on all the time?
Yes, I'm going to be on several times, and then, of course, they're going to be so crazy about me, they're going to have me on every week. I'm sure
terrific.
To replace Perry Mason.
Thank you for that. Okay, Gene Rayburn saying so long for Match Game 73. Join us next time.
Today's consolation prizes are a West clock, direct reading digital dial light alarm clock, wood grain finish lighted dial, backed by years of experience, West clocks, a Tally Industries company, and a supply of new No Drip Good Humor, rich, creamy tasting ice cream, specially made to melt slow, drip less. Doesn't mess you up, that's good humor. This is Johnny Olson speaking for Match Game 73, a Mark Goodson, Bill Todman production.